Right now, hello everybody. David Dilling from Markzware, and today we have one of our valued customers, Lori Miskoff from Media Trends LC, right?
LC, yes.
Right. Excellent, excellent. And today Lori's going to share with us some experiences with the Markzware products, Q2ID, Quark to InDesign in this case. But before we jump into that, Lori, can you maybe tell us a little bit about, first of all, how did you get involved in graphic design?
Well, that's a long story. My husband started out as a newspaper reporter, and I was working as a phone company outside plant engineer. But in 1982, he decided to start his own printing company, something he always wanted to do. And I decided I would join him. So we got into the quick print industry, which was very big at the time. Mm-hmm. And because he was a journalist, and he also was teaching at Rutgers part-time, we picked up a few newspaper customers. So the newspapers became a bigger part of our clientele. And finally, in 1990, we sold the quick print, and we went completely to pre-press. And we were just doing layout of school newspapers, high school and colleges. Mm-hmm. So it turned into a pretty big business. At one time, I had about 50 clients. And it was, I had a full-time graphic designer also working for me, and it was really rolling. Things have kind of slowed down since then. Budgets have changed. Obviously some schools have stopped printing and go on online completely. But, you know, I still have my clientele, and we also do websites now. You know, we've moved into that as well.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just, you know, a little bit of a side question. What do you make your websites in? Which programs?
WordPress.
WordPress, yeah, excellent, yeah.
I've long ago figured, why reinvent the wheel? And it's a good basic, you know, the framework is great. It's really based on blogs, so it's really good for news websites, which is what we handle. Mm-hmm. So it's a good product.
Yeah, no, we use it as well a lot, so that's, very good. And now, you already touched on it, but, so that, you know, I guess you already touched that, actually, what your company does, so that, we've got two questions in one there.
Yeah, we consider ourselves a publishing service, and we're, you know, our focus is schools, high schools and colleges, the newspaper, so we do different levels of service. We can do layout from scratch. So the students will give us their stories and their photos, and we'll do the layout. At other times, the students will do their own files, either QuarkXPress or InDesign, sometimes Publisher.
Yeah.
And in the old days, it was PageMaker. But in any case, I will get a semi-completed or mostly completed file, and I'll go through it. I'll even out columns. I'll make sure the pictures are CMYK if they're in color, and you know, make sure the black pictures that are going to print well.
Right.
So and then sometimes I also just get PDFs, and I work in PDFs too. You know, I'll pre-flight the PDF, and I'll open up pictures and adjust them, and you know, get everything ready for print. And then we broker the printing. I work with several presses, and based on the number, the quantity of the paper, the type of paper that's going out, I, you know, make a decision based on what's best for the customer as far as which press I work with.
Right. Yeah. We get a lot of quite a few still, publisher files. A lot of them are from, yearbooks, schools, that sort of, a niche of the market. So it's a big thing, yeah.
Yeah, publisher, it's kind of a pain in the neck. I'm not fond of working publisher files, but you know, you have to do what they send you.
Yeah, no, exactly. What are some of the tools you use in your workflow? You mentioned pre-flighting and other things. What's a little bit your workflow tools?
Well, I actually kept Quark very a long time. I love QuarkXPress. I think it was very intuitive for myself. It just worked very well. And I was just going back and looking at my files before, you know, this interview, and I really had some schools that I kept in QuarkXPress up until 2015. But in the meantime, a little earlier, you know, I saw what was happening with InDesign. I did not like the first couple of versions of InDesign, but somewhere around 3, you know, it really started to take on a good personality. But by InDesign 4, I had taken some of my schools and converted my own personal files to InDesign files. So now at this point, I'm completely in design. But and then, of course, the ones that were in Quark, I can use Q2ID to make the change. And, of course, I'm in Photoshop, I'm in Illustrator, and I'm in Acrobat. So those are my basic software tools.
Right, so you're pre-flighting with Acrobat or
PDFs? I am pre-flighting with Acrobat. I'm kind of very hands-on. I like to get into I consider myself very well-versed in PDF. And I like to get into the PDF now that you can. I mean, obviously, when PDFs came out, you couldn't touch them.
No.
But now it's great. I mean, I can go in there and, you know, do practically anything. So,
well, how did you learn about Q2ID and Markzware?
Well, Markzware has been around for a long time. And we used to go to the Seybold conferences when we had our quick print. And they always had a, you know, you had a table, a booth.
Yeah.
And we also belong to the National Association of Quick Printers and the New Jersey Association of Quick Printers, and go to those expos, and Markzware was usually there.
Yeah, yeah, okay, excellent.
Trade or shows. Adobe would have, sometimes Adobe, I think, would have
the
free samples.
In the early days, yeah.
Right? Yeah, I think I might still have some of those floating around.
Yeah.
The flight check.
You had flight check, I heard of flight check before?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard of flight check a long time ago.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that's our pre-flight tool. You might want to check it out. It also checks PDFs, but also, more importantly, our focus is the native file, so the Quark or the InDesign or other file types, you know.
I should definitely take a look at that.
Yeah, it's just drag and drop any file, basically, onto the flight check icon, then you see what it tells you. It's really interesting.
But, I bet.
Yeah. Anyway, okay, so great. So that's how you heard about – and when did you finally, you know, what drove you to make the decision to switch to Quark to InDesign? You sort of just touched on it, and then, you know,
Well, when I started making the transition from Quark to InDesign, I was doing it manually with my own files, but I still had customers who would send me their Quark files. And actually, one of the main reasons that gave me the impetus is that my Quark version 9 started crashing upon opening.
Oh.
So... not helpful.
No.
And at that point, I went to Q2. As soon as it started crashing, I said, I know a product that's going to help me. So I got Q2ID and, started opening up Quark files like there was nothing to it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's the next question. A little bit. Let's dive into that a little bit. Actually, one step backwards. I was like to ask is how was the installation process, the acquisition, installation?
I don't really remember. I think that
I guess that's good.
That's good. No, that is good because I think it was just very easy. I just got it. I downloaded it. I installed it. And then it shows up on the menu in my InDesign. It says Markzware.
Yep.
And it says convert to, Quark file to InDesign. Click on that. It opens up. And you now have an InDesign file, and you go from there. It was really easy.
Yeah. And what are some of the the pros are quite obvious, I think. You just, one-click conversion. Are there any cons or anything you need to touch up? Or?
Yes. Yeah, definitely. One of the main things I find is that InDesign has a default letting of 120%. And being a newspaper layout person... Yeah. The default letting is 110%. We usually do 10 over 11. So all my Quark files were set up that way, and most of my InDesign files I already have set up that way. But when I open Q2ID, I can immediately tell that it's 10 over 12. But because I've done everything in style sheets, I can just go into body copy, make one change, in the Quark justification window, not Quark, I'm sorry, in the InDesign justification window, and change it from 120 to 110, and then everything goes back. And that clears up a lot of stuff. Fonts, if the name is different, like I was checking an old file just the other day to see, Helvetica used to be Helvetica Bold Condensed, but now when I open it up, it's looking for Helvetica Condensed Bold. So all the bold condensed would come up with the pink highlighting in the new InDesign file. So, again, it's just a matter of going into the font area and, changing those particular fonts that are showing as not available.
Right.
But, or any fonts that I may have used on an old computer that I don't have anymore, obviously would have to be updated. Other than that, It seems to work very smoothly. I mean, in an older version, sometimes the pictures wouldn't come in. They'd come in as just sort of gray with the X.
Gray preview, and yeah.
You wouldn't see the picture. But recently, that hasn't happened.
Well, we do have some bugs here and there. You know, it's a constant struggle because the Quark and InDesign, they're always, you know, adding new versions and the OS is changing. And so if you find any oddities, please do report them to Markzware. I'll put a link here to the support form because we want to hear that because generally we can fix it, you know. And also that letting problem, we should check into that as well. But in any event, like you said, hopefully it's just a small change in most cases and, you know.
It's 5 minutes maybe. So it's real. And then it's an InDesign file at that point. You save it. And I'm ready to go.
Yeah. So I guess, you know, would you recommend Q2ID to other people considering buying it or switching?
Definitely. I mean, I have Quark files that are 20 years old, at least, that I can still access. I have old ones probably, but...
Yeah.
And I just tested them the other day with Q2ID, and they came up beautifully.
Right.
So if you have... an archive of Quark files, it's a really good way to change it to InDesign.
Right.
Very quickly.
Right. Converts everything, you know, like you said.
Exactly.
Colors, exactly. Fonts, images, styles, boom, right on in.
It's just really very seamless. And, you know, you don't even, I mean, you're using this one command, but you're opening up a file and it opens up as an InDesign file. So you're never really seeing Quark. And, you know, you just go from there.
Yeah, right. Good. That's a good point. You don't even need Quark on your system to convert these old or even new Quark files. You just need the Markzware plugin loaded in InDesign, and it's like you described,
exactly.
Very easy. Yeah, yeah.
Well, Q2ID is just so simple to use. You know, the fact that you can open a Quark file and it immediately becomes an InDesign file, and then you go from there is what makes it work so well.
Because that is what we strive to do over the years to provide to the customers, really a one-click conversion. Like you said, a couple oddities here and there you have to check out, but excellent. That's the idea. So.
There's three reasons that I would use Q2ID. One is if your Quark program is crashing, which happened in my case, and I couldn't even open a Quark file. The other is if clients are sending you Quark files and you want to put them in InDesign.
Yep.
And the other is if you have an archive of old Quark files and you need to update them to InDesign.
Yeah.
It works every way.
Yeah. Excellent. Very, very good. Those are the three main reasons. Exactly. Very, very well said. Okay. All right, Laurie. Well, thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome.
Really appreciate it. Where can people find more information about your company in New Jersey?
Okay. Well, our website is mediatrends.org. O-R-G, mm-hmm. And people can also email me at Lori, that's L-O-R-I, at mediatrends.org.
Excellent. Well, once again, really thank you for the time, for sharing your experiences with Markzware Q2ID, and we wish you all the best for your husband, yourself, and your business.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Nice to talk to you.
Yeah.